Hello?
All right, cool. I have to get used to actually using the microphone. Welcome to the Delaware County Symphony Chamber Series. Thank you so much for coming. I'm Michael Berton, the principal cello and Robert F. Sweeney chair of the Delaware County Symphony. I'm also co-director of the Chamber Series along with Laura Goughan, who you'll hear from a little later on. We're so excited to bring you this program meant for people of all ages with five extremely different works. They're all very cool. Including After Intermission, Peter and the Wolf. Coming up second on the program will be the first movement of Camille Saint-Saens' Violin Concerto No. 3, performed by violinist Kai Freeman and pianist Jungeun Kim. Every year, the DCS holds a youth concerto competition, and every year, dozens of the area's very best youth soloists audition for the chance to play their concerto with the orchestra. This year is the start of what we hope to be an annual tradition where we invite one of the finalists to come play at this final chamber series. And we're so excited to showcase Kai's talents on this stage. I was listening to him a little bit earlier and he's gonna knock your socks off. But first, I will be playing for you a piece called Canon by Ilse and Ziah. All of you, I'm sure, know the tune to Pachelbel's Canon, whether or not you could sing it right now. I'll tell you, it is the bane of a cellist's existence. There are roughly 8 notes, and then you play it again, and again, and again, and again, and again, nonstop for, I don't know, 5-6 minutes. Well, Ilse Ziah, who is a cellist and arranger, she arranged this for solo cello, so obviously it's going to be a lot more fun for the cellist. I hope you'll like it, too. If you ever happen to see me playing a wedding or some other gig, probably 80% of my music comes from this person, so big fan of hers. Thank you again for coming. As a reminder, you can find out more news about us at dcsmusic.org. You can sign up for our email list. Our next symphony concert will be May 7th here at Neumann, and we'll be opening up Rose Tree Park's summer concert series on June 21st. And as part of the concert, we'll actually be playing Peter and the Wolf as well. So thank you again, and I'll be back on stage in a minute.
Thank you.
Good afternoon, everyone. I did the same thing with the microphone. I'm not used to using it. My name is Laura Goughan, and I am one of the other directors of our chamber series, along with Michael Berton. Thank you so much again for being here this afternoon. For the next portion of our program, we're going to start off with a duet by Rossini. This is one of his most famous duets. It's titled Duetto Buffo di Due Gati. It's a very serious piece that has become very important for the vocal literature. Following that, we have selections of fife and drum by our very own Katherine Hajec. These pieces, some of them that you'll hear, are actually originally Irish folk tunes that were brought over during the Civil War by Irish immigrants. They became very famous. We also have another piece in there called Grandfather's Clock. This was written by Henry Clay Work. This became so popular, it sold over a million copies. And that's actually the reason why we call it a grandfather clock, is because of his piece. Following that, we'll have a brief intermission, and we'll have our performance of Peter and the Wolf. Thank you so much again for being here. I also want to point out, we have visual program notes. I really recommend that you take a second during our intermission to take a look at those. There's a lot of more in-depth information about each of the pieces that you'll hear today. Thank you again, and here is Duetto Buffo di Due Gati.
Let me tell you a story. This is the story of Peter and the Wolf. It's a musical story where the characters are represented by different instruments of the orchestra. For example, the bird is represented by the flute. The duck by the oboe. The cat by the clarinet. The grandfather by the bassoon. Finally, our parade of characters is completed by a group of hunters, the firing of their rifles punctuated by the timpani. Well now, let us begin our story. Early one morning, Peter opened the gate and went out into the big green meadow. Thank you. came waddling around. She was glad that Peter had not closed the gate, and she decided to take a nice swim in the deep pond in the meadow, and she jumped into the water. The cat thought, the bird is busy arguing. I'll just grab him. Stealthily, she crept towards him on her velvet paws.
Thank you.
father's words. Boys like him are simply not afraid of wolves. By the hand, locked the gate, and led him home. And in her excitement, foolishly jumped out of the pond. No matter how hard the duck tried to run, she couldn't escape the wolf. He was getting nearer, and nearer, and nearer, catching up with her. Stood. The cat was sitting on one branch. The bird on another branch. But not too close to that cat. wolf stalked round and round the tree, looking at all of them with greedy eyes. Touched the wolf's head with his wings while the wolf snapped at him again and again and again. The wolf was very angry.
Thank you.
out of the woods came the hunters. Following the wolf's trail and firing their rifles as they went.
Thank you.
carefully, you can hear the duck quacking inside of the wolf, because the wolf, in his hurry, and with an unfortunate lack of decorum, had swallowed her alive.